One Stone Battery is one of the largest Dover coastal artillery batteries. 2X naval 15-inch guns with a range of 42,000 yards. These guns were called Jane and Clem. Jane was named after the young lady in the strip cartoon in the Daily Mirror, and Clem was probably named after Winston Churchill's wife, Clementine. They were operated from a separate control room and were manned by the 25 men of the Royal Marine Siege Regiment. Located near the battery is an anti-aircraft battery. To view this, click the card above or see description. Four massive shell and cordite magazines, two for each gun, still exist under tons of concrete and soil. To see these, click the card above or see description.
You can see how much they cleared off though, look.
Yeah, that's true, the mud wise.
Right, yeah then folks, so it's the new year, it's 2019, and yes, I got flu on New Year's Eve. Didn't see New Year's Day through, so.
Did you not actually get to midnight?
No, 11:30 I went to bed. So, mad, isn't it? So yeah, it's just, we've been listening on the internet, watching, listening, and all that jazz, folks. One Stone Battery has been, what's the word? Excavated. Yeah. Excavated. One of the gun positions. Clem, is it, this one? Or Jane or Clem? Clem?
I'm not sure which.
Why not? Why don't you know? But yes, we're basically going to have a look, see what they've done, folks. Indeed. Be sure to check out the website, which is linked right there, folks. All stuff going on there. Yeah. Got some new keyrings as well.
Are we doing that now?
Yeah, why not?
I was going to look at them.
New keyrings, folks. These are only available
limited edition.
Limited edition here. So the next ones we make will be different pictures. So check them out. Chris is holding them there. So what's this one? This is a double-sided one, that.
That was double-sided. And that's got two idiots on it.
Yeah, that's us.
Yeah. Or if you don't want to look at us.
That's a Cold War one. You know how we love the Cold War, folks. These are, paper has been printed on print paper. So it's like shiny, glossy. Absolutely amazing.
Good quality.
Good quality indeed, folks. I had to do these myself because the original ones that we got, paid someone to do, they messed them up. They put them onto photo, not photo, they put them onto
A4 office paper, basically.
Office paper, yeah. And it was.
And they printed them the wrong way around.
Yeah.
Which,
they squashed them.
So from now on, we're doing it ourselves.
Yep, definitely. So there's going to be some great ones coming. These are the first ones, so be kind, folks. These are our first attempt at this.
Yeah, so there's, I think there's what, is there 25 of these? No, about 20.
Something like
something
that. Yeah, whatever.
And then that'll be that, and we'll do something different.
Yeah, yeah. There won't be any more of these being made. So yeah, check
limited
out the website,
folks.
Limited edition indeed. Looking forward to making more.
But we can't until you bought this lot, obviously.
That's it, yeah. So,
also, folks, we have available is the ICAS beanie hats. Check the link below to find out more.
Hope you had a nice new year and Christmas and all that, folks. So yeah, let's have a look at the One Stone and see what we got. Chris is going to look up for some information. Information indeed. So look at this concrete here, this is like hard standing, isn't it? Not they have in airports. That's one of the massive gun positions, right there. Right in the corners, these tower things. That's the camouflage netting towers. Got one there as well. I think the other one's gone, isn't it?
What?
Netting tower.
Where?
Because there's two that side and there's one this side.
Maybe, I don't know, maybe they use the end of the building where the hooks are.
Maybe.
Because, but I do think on the pictures I've seen, there was like a scaffolding structure over the gun.
Right.
Then bits on the side there, there was mesh over different bits.
Right.
I don't think it was just the concrete bits that supported it. But now I'm trying to find the pictures, it won't happen, will it?
Right, so who's doing this? National Trust?
National Trust.
They've bought this land.
Bought the site.
And they're basically excavating it for the public.
Yeah.
To come and see and enjoy, folks. But it doesn't look like they've done anything more since.
I think they've only done it the last couple of weeks. So
well, it actually is just, it's still the new year week one, isn't it?
Like, yeah, I mean, yeah, we'll let them off.
Yeah.
We've got, I don't know how much they're doing, that's the other thing.
Right.
Really.
Got some buildings down there, original World War II. The cool thing here, they've greased up the old doors, folks, WD-40 or something like that. So it's opens up smooth as a board.
But they do need grease on that if it is just WD-40. Now drainage, all the drainage has been exposed. It's another room. This door's sealed, can't go in there. But it's good to see the original doors though, it really is. Let's see if we can have a look. Look at the thickness of this. Look at that room there, right there, that looks proper, a hardened room, that one. And you've got the hooks above it on there, for camouflage. Camouflage indeed. Let's have a look in here. There's not much. We done this anyway some months ago when we was up here in the fog and the rain. What have you got for us, Chris?
It just says Jane and Clem.
Right, there's 15 inch guns. That's mad. 15 inch. Right, should we leave that then, because it's getting dark now?
There's a thing in here.
All this needs digging out, because this is another pit where the gun would swivel around.
It'd be nice even if they built one out of wood or something to have like a dummy gun just to show the size, wouldn't it?
Yeah. It wouldn't take too much. Is it done by volunteers, this? I don't know. Chris uses Facebook more than me, folks.
I don't know. It's quite interesting to see, because we didn't realise it had metal around the bottom.
Yeah. Plating.
And you need a big spanner to undo that very big nut.
Seen a big nut like that somewhere before, haven't we?
Yeah. That was underground, though.
Yeah.
This is above ground nut.
And it goes up over there, look.
It makes me wonder quite how big the garden was.
It's like this, it's all drainage up here, look.
Yeah. Was the barrel of the gun on this tour, or was the barrel of the gun sticking out over the field there?
I suppose it would have...
Would have been here.
It would have gone this way somewhere else. It swivelled anyway, so
this must be a massive, great piece of concrete under here. Did you see the sheer size of that? It's huge.
And this is one.
Yeah.
Of two on this site. And there's two more gun sites like this. Winnie and...
At least one got blown up though, didn't
it? I'm not sure.
Winnie, it's all... It's lumps of concrete everywhere.
Oh, what, blown up after the war?
Yeah.
Yeah, Chris, get down in that water, see, so see the size of...
No. I'll do my little bit.
Yeah, it's pretty deep. I love the slanted. It reminds me of a German gun battery.
Yeah. I know they've obviously just cleared a bit so you can see the size, but it'd be nice to have the whole thing uncovered.
Yeah, they have to do it. If they've just stopped now, that's bad. Jesus, there's a plane coming. That's the camouflage netting again. What are these expense stores under here?
I'm not sure, they must be.
It's quite cool, isn't it? So they put loads of logs under there, so it's like... It might be for the old farmer.
Probably just because what else do you do with them? At least they're under there, they could probably be used as logs, can't they?
Yeah. It's hard to think though, a 15 inch gun, a gun with a 15 inch barrel was right there, folks. Absolutely amazing, one of the biggest ones. Like Todd Battery, what was the fitness of them barrels? I can't remember. They were proper big though, folks. Proper big. If you want to see that video, click the link above. Battery Todd, when we went to France. Absolutely amazing. Drain. Railway tracks. Are the tracks still there?
Yeah, I said, yeah.
Where?
Here.
I want proof.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, look at that. This is the guns. So that would have been carrying the ammunition from the actual gun stores, the ammo stores.
Cut off and they've left this in here
because
it's under concrete.
Yeah.
Jesus!
What have we got here? Look at this old gear. This is the artifacts found when they've been excavating this
lawnmower. Site.
Yeah, classic stuff. Old bed springs. Yeah. Bit of corrugated tin sorted here.
So there was two tracks?
Yeah.
There must have been quite a lot coming down here then.
Be good to get the groove dug out.
Yeah. I wonder if the hooks are still there.
For the, you reckon that is?
It's red at the bottom. Fire. Right there. It'll be painted red and that would have been a fire bucket.
Wow.
Do you reckon that's a bench? Or do you reckon that's a bit more important than
not that? Not too sure, mate, not too sure. We can see all the roadways leading off and stuff like that, folks.
Nice to see it clear though, isn't it?
It is.
I just noticed, you can see it's in its own little area now. You've got it's fenced off, all nice, a nice new fence. And that side, look. So it isn't actually, so it is completely contained and separate.
Yeah. Wow. Didn't know it was that deep down. Christ.
Can we do that next?
Yeah.
Right. We can use, we'll use this picture, Gary's picture, off the IKS page. That was it last year.
Wow, yeah, you can see the plough field there as well. Now look at it. That's, come on, go down there, Chris, down on the, show the size of it, folks.
It does show how much World War II
stuff. Yeah, that's proper deep though, isn't it? Look at that.
Just covered it up. Because even when you're
ploughing, it would never go this deep, would it? No. Can you come down here a minute, Ian? That's
amazing. So these are Nissan huts? Yeah. So the internet says. So look. You can see, obviously, the field was quite high, and even along the edge of the building, you can see the earth mark, can't you?
Yeah. Wow. These are located behind the gun positions. What was it, crew quarters?
I don't know.
I think they were crew quarters. I wonder what sort of artifacts were found here. It's like bullets and all sorts, folks. There must be.
Do you reckon they had a metal detector on site?
No.
Drain there. Look at that, look.
Oh wow. It's all been flushed through as well.
See, I'm thinking that. Oh, it's all the way around. All these holes.
So
drainage. I thought it was something to do with the structure, but look. You look down these holes.
Are they?
Well, look over here. You can see the one over here's cleaned out. Look.
You sure that's not just where a stake would have been? Where they
I don't really know how they were built.
It's not really on the drain bit, is it? The drain's next. I don't know, I'm just chucking it out there as well.
Yeah.
Like, this is the walkway between the two Nissan huts. It's crazy. Metal detector would be good. Need the World War II history hunter here, folks. I think we all know him. Don't know his face, though. Know his voice.
That's much deeper than I thought.
That is good to see, isn't it?
You can't tell the pictures, can you?
No.
It's crazy. That's suppose back in the day when it was built, this would have been how it was built. It'd be landscaped at the sides, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Protection.
Try and find a bullet, Chris.
Haven't got a metal detector.
No, it should be on the surface.
Right. What about a stick?
Original doors. Lovely. Green paint still on them, folks. And the red undercoat. And the shuttering and stuff like that. It is lovely. Lovely to see. Right, so we can get on top of this thing.
Yeah, it's got the pipes and chimney and stuff.
Oh wow, so that's for the stove one, isn't it? One for the stove. And just ventilation.
There's three ventilation ones.
Don't want to get your foot caught down there. Look at that, it's like a bloody swimming pool.
Massive, isn't it? I'm just surprised it's still all there underground. It's
yeah. So when the farmer had took it over again, then it was like...
Just get rid of the nests and huts and cover it up.
Yeah.
Which was nice, so they didn't demolish all this. They could have pushed all this into there.
Yeah.
I suppose it was too much, you know, too big a job to demolish it all. Look at that.
When they get rid of that left-hand bit with the bush and that is, that would be much bloody amazing. Yeah, so National Trust have done a great job, folks. Great job indeed. Hopefully they'll be able to have some sort of calf here as well. That'd be nice. I know they got it at Langdon Cliffs. They got a calf and that there, but have a little car park over there somewhere and people can come in and they can spend a day here. Picnic benches, that'd be great. That's a great idea.
Or pub.
Micro pub.
Right, are we going to go and see if they check out a magazine?
Well, I want to look for some bullets first before we start anything else, if that's all right. Right, so we found a picture then, Chris.
Yes.
It's sort of around this area, it looks
here's
like.
Here's the railway lines. This might not be this gun, though. It might be the other gun.
Yeah, yeah. But where that is over there, the pit for the gun, this is what was there.
That's big.
You see the gun there, that big square thing, and you got the in front of it.
This would have been the tractor that we were just sent about. They would have gone through.
Yeah.
Taking the shells to the store.
Oh, it's got cordite on his little tractor thing there. For the gun, look at the size of it, 15 inches.
Yeah.
And that would have been over there. Jesus. What other pictures is there?
That's how big the breech is. That doesn't look like here. Look at the metalwork above it.
It's inside that gun case, mate.
Is it? Right.
Inside the casing. Wow.
So really, the gun had like an armoured outer cover, didn't it?
Yeah. The breech.
There's Winston Churchill here. Right. That shows how big it is compared to people. So it was mounted on that middle bit and it slid round on that flat area then.
Yeah. See the tracks look, in front of it?
Yeah.
Those tracks are there.
Yeah. Seems to be more tracks on here though.
Oh, middle one.
What's that all about?
We're finding real history here today, folks. Real history. It's great to look at old-fashioned photos like that, and we're actually there and we're looking at the site and sort of comparing.
This is what I mean. Look, if you look at this, maybe I'll make it bigger if I do that or not. Yeah, here, see them two concrete posts with the netting on the top.
Right,
that's there. Them two posts.
Right there.
That's what I was saying. It wasn't the camo netting over the gun position here. It's scaffolding.
Right. So it's just covering them bays up?
Yeah, there's two posts. If you go this way a little bit.
So I thought it was something to do with the covering the gun.
Yeah, I saw this the other
day. Whereabouts was that picture taken then?
You've got the two posts. It looks like there's a bit on the top of the post there, but that might just be metalwork.
Yeah.
Just to cover up the... And then the gun itself had its own scaffolding sort of cover over it. Which looks like it's actually fitted to the gun, so maybe when they move the gun, the scaffolding moved with it.
Right.
which was right there.
So it's sort of taken from somewhere here, isn't it?
I reckon. No, it's got a hump there. It must be like back there somewhere, on the corner.
The other side of the railway tracks.
Yeah, because all this...
Yeah, obviously that weren't here. That's the one I was looking for, though. About them. So that would have been the same here. I wonder why there's only one. They must have, like we said, they must have gone from there to the hooks on that building.
Might have, because there's no buildings the other side.
No.
That's good though, good find. Amazing.
The barrel of that gun, if you look here, it's over the railway track.
This track that we're on.
So, it obviously goes 360.
Wow.
So the barrel would be here, like up there.
15 inch. Mad, isn't it? Really is mad.
There's a railway train, there's a train there as well.
Where's the train?
Wagon.
Oh yeah, in the corner there. On the train. Tracks.
That's crazy.
There's three more of these sites that are still buried, folks. Well, you say one of them's demolished as well, when they've done the farming field.
That field was for sale.
Right. But there's nothing there.
I don't know what's left. There's loads of lumps of concrete sticking out. That'll be in a future film. We'll have a look.
We'll have a look, folks, yeah. Maybe with a metal detector.
Yeah, why not? Yeah. I don't know, because it's all got reinforcing in it. It could just be a...
That'd be fun. It'd be fun. Oh, good boy, fun now, folks. Jesus. All right. So, yeah, we get a cleaner example of the railway track there, folks.
And that would have gone all the way along and fed all the guns on this side of the road.
Yeah. Amazing.
You know where they came from, don't you? Where did it come off the... Where did it branch off the main line?
I'm not sure. I can't find that information out right now. What's that? So we just found out, folks. Come back.
Get your phone out. Because that's why there's some two extra trenches in the picture.
Right, so...
Well, that one. Where's that other picture we had a minute ago?
I haven't touched anything, mate.
There. No, not that one. That one is that one, isn't it? Right, we'll just use this picture because I found it, alright?
Alright. What example?
Example. Yeah.
Is it railway track lines here?
Yes. When we were saying about the gun, where the barrel was over the railway track, you see the three lines?
Yeah.
Well, you've got railway track, because that's a bit the railway track went in.
Yeah.
You've got drain.
Which is the middle line.
And then you've got here, you've got a metal bit there, for the railway track.
So that's that.
So you had two tracks each side of the gun.
But
as
the
you see there, three and three, you've got three more there.
Right, let's have a look. That's one set, and this is the other set.
Yeah, so you've had track, drain, track. The difference here, they pulled the track out.
Yeah, and that side hasn't got the drain in the centre.
Many of the British batteries remained until the decision was taken to retire all coastal artillery in 1956. The big 15-inch guns at Wanstone Farm were not removed until 1959.